such a great yearbook, you guys. My favorite part is looking at all of their teachers, so you can remember what your teachers look like when you were in ninth grade, right?
And seeing your teachers, like, you don't even know what they look like.
Now I
can know. Now I can know.
Buzzy, what's your favorite? Oh, yes, yes, that one. Where's the USB from the summer? Yes, of course. Hey, Mrs. Throckmorton here, and you just saw some of the highlights of the 2013 school year yearbook. And I would like to tell you how you can order yours today. It's not too late. Even if your photo's not in, your name is at least printed in this yearbook. So definitely get yours and remember this year. Remember your classmates, remember your teachers. It's something to hold on to for your whole life and look back on. What you can do is go on the main page, and there is a link where you can click on to get the order form for this yearbook. And you can send a check with that form to me at the Exton office, and we will ship this yearbook to you before the end of the school year. So please get them in as soon as you can, but you have until the end of the school year to order your yearbook.
Thank you, Mrs. Throckmorton, for that yearbook announcement, so it's not too late to order a yearbook. Happy Friday, guys!
Yeah, happy Friday!
It's Friday. It's the last Friday before school's out.
Wait, so these are our last announcements?
These are the last announcements of the school year.
Okay, well, that's a lot of pressure, so we better make this good.
All right, well, in typical fashion, let's start it off with a pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
So first up on the agenda today, we have box tops for education. And if you're like, what are box tops? They're on like your cereal boxes and cookie boxes. They're everywhere. So start collecting them, snip them out, send them into your nearest center or to the Exton office. There's more information below, but start collecting them because they help our school. They give us money.
Okay, great. Yeah, why not? Have you taken the mentor survey yet? Please look below for a link for a survey so you can tell us all about how great your mentors are.
Yeah, that's really important. Hey, you know what? I was just thinking, the West, they did a flashback to like their best announcements of the year.
Oh yeah?
Yeah.
I wonder what some of my favorite announcements were this year.
I'm on my cell phone trying to go.
Thank you, Cole Hamels, for earning some of your bajillion-dollar contract this year. With your 17th win on Sunday, you gave the Phillies a chance to at least finish above 500. Sorry to Mr. Riegert and Pirates fans for missing out on that opportunity.
Some really fun announcements. I totally forgot how much awesome stuff we did this year.
I know, it's really been a great year.
You know what's fun, too?
What's that?
Bounce houses.
Whoa! Are you coming to the graduation celebration? We have graduation in the East and in the West on June 15th. immediately after graduation is a graduation celebration party.
Ooh.
And there's going to be food and games, and in the East we're going to have a bounce house. There's going to be goodie bags. There's going to be face painting. There's going to be USB tattoos. You want to be there. Bring your friends and family, but you need to RSVP. So please look at the link below and RSVP to the graduation celebration.
You know, I think there's going to be a special guest appearance by Buzzy the Bee. Well, that's what I heard. I mean, I know he's very busy. He's an extremely busy guy, but
I mean, that's reason enough right there to go.
You've got to meet Buzzy. If you made it all the way through the school and haven't met Buzzy, now's the time.
Yeah, you can get a picture with Buzzy.
Yeah.
With your cap and gown. How cool is that?
That'd be awesome. And let's see, we're going to kick it over to Book Corner for an end of the year book celebration.
Hi, welcome to the last Book Corner of the year. I'm Mrs. Thompson.
And I'm Mrs. DeMascola.
I see you're all ready for summer.
I am. It's coming quickly, guys. A few more days.
She's got her hat and her sunglasses, but don't forget your books. Don't forget to read over the summer. Check out the Moodle link below us on the homepage for the Book Corner. On there, I have links to some great sources for books for teenagers over the summer.
And the English department staff also put their favorite recommendations, so you can check those out too and see which teachers like which books.
Great. The link's going to be up all summer, so click on that Book Corner link and let us know what you're reading over the summer. You can add your favorite books to the list as well.
Good idea. Well, have a great summer, guys. Be sure to read and let us know what books you read when you come back in September. Take care, guys.
Bye.
All right. Thanks, English teachers, for those great summer reads.
You know, since we had a final Book Corner, I think it's only fair that Science Corner gets a final one as well.
Sounds good to me. Take it away, Science Corner.
In the spirit of where we're going to change the density using salt, we have an egg here, and Miss Graham is going to put that in our regular, just plain old water, and regular eggs will sink. They are more dense than the water. So next we're going to make some salt water. Hopefully we can make it really salty. And if we make it salty enough, this water is becoming more dense by adding the salt. So now this water is more dense, hopefully, than this egg, if we've done it correctly, and it will float. Very carefully.
Break the egg.
Yes. Try not to break your egg. Oh, almost. It was less.
Just keep, yeah, let's add some more salt.
If we add more, maybe, ooh, it will bring it up. If we were able to stir.
You can see that the saltier we make the solution, the more that the egg starts to float. Is that why it's so easy to float in the ocean?
Yeah, exactly. And in the salt, in the Dead Sea, which is an extremely salty sea, then you really float in that environment.
Very cool. So salt, adding salt to water makes it, increases its density.
Mm-hmm. And that's our experiments for today. Thanks for joining us at Science Corner.
See you guys later.
So long.
Thanks, Science Corner. I'm really glad we got to see that fun experiment. I learned a lot about density.
Yeah. As always, have a wonderful summer. We are ready to kick back and start enjoying our summer vacation.
Yeah, I hope you guys do too, but don't forget, you do have school Monday and Tuesday, so don't forget to log in and get all those assignments done. And to finish off the year strong, here's our message from our principal, Mrs. Rupp. Have a great summer, guys.
Hi, everybody. I just wanted to take a few moments to wish you all a wonderful summer break. You have all worked so hard this year, and you've made my first year here at Achievement House one that I will never forget. You all have been supportive. You've been wonderful. I have loved meeting a lot of you and talking with you. And as you can see, I've started my summer break a little bit early. I'm vacationing here in Hawaii, and it is great. I hope that your summer is as great as my 1 week here is going to be. See you in the